Listen, Eden is kingdom, and Eden mindset is a kingdom mindset.
Let me hear ya. Where my Eden citizens at? Where my Eden citizens at? Where you at? Let me see you do your hands like this. Here we go.
When God made man, he made a spirit. It was his plan.
Boy, you ain't Jesus. Who do you think you are? You ain't Jesus. Only Jesus can walk on the water. You gonna drown, boy. Devil was talking to him. Yes, you gonna drown, boy. You don't see that boat was wind?
Come on, preacher. Come on, man.
And immediately, Peter saw. When he began to observe the boisterous wind, he got his attention off of what Jesus had said.
He
began to focus on the boisterous wind. Then he began to sing. Jesus got him up and said, why did you doubt?
Come on.
I told you the curtain. That's good enough. How did it don't matter what kind of storm is going on? When he even saw what this tree was about,
yes,
and she saw,
yes,
she dropped the ball.
Uh-huh.
Defeat and failure only comes when we drop the ball.
That's right. Yeah.
We don't know who we are.
That's right.
We truly don't know who we are.
That's right. That's right.
Defeat and failure only comes when we drop the ball. When we take our eyes off what God says and begin to dwell on what the serpent said.
That's right. That's right.
And that's what happened to Eve and God, and that's what happened to Peter while on the water.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Look at verse number 6 again. So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, three things occurred. The Apostle John, in 1 John chapter 2, you can write this. 1 John chapter 2, and I'm going to read it. 1 John chapter 2, verses 15 and 16, he gives those three things that occur.
That's it. That's it.
He said, do not love the world.
All right.
All the things in the world.
Yes.
If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him.
That's right.
For all that is in the world, what he says, and watch the sequence order that he puts in.
That's it.
He says, the lust of the flesh. So first thing, that's how he made it.
Yes, sir.
Then he says, the lust of the eyes and the pride of life.
That's right.
Is not of the Father, but is of the world.
Oh, right.
Now let's look back at Genesis chapter 3, verse 6. And look at the same order. Find the same order there.
That's right. Same order.
So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, when she saw that the tree was good for food, it's the lust of the flesh.
Yes, sir.
Oh, I know y'all know that. Don't we know me? When she saw that the tree was good for food,
yes, sir.
That's
right.
Let me come up next. That it was pleasant to the eye. The lust of the eye.
That's right.
And a tree desirable to make one wise.
Come on.
Pride of
the eye. That's right. Yes, sir.
And she took of this fruit and she ate it. But she didn't stop there.
Oh, sir.
Pride do not like being alone.
Come on.
Pride don't like being alone. So pride gave. So what she did, she gave to her husband.
That's it.
And he ate.
Yes, sir.
She didn't want to be the only one a partaker of sin.
That's right.
She didn't want to be the only one standing before God and saying and answering for her sin.
All right.
She wanted to be able to have a scapegoat.
Yes, sir.
That's an Adam you gave me. Yes. You made him first.
Right.
He ate too. Pride does. Hallelujah.
Amen.
She gave him a husband, and he did eat.
Right?
Now look at verse number 7. Then the eyes of both of them were open.
Yeah.
And watch this. And they knew that they were naked. And they sold what? They sold fig leaves together and made themselves coverings. Now, let's look at the first part. Their eyes were open.
Yeah.
And they knew that they were naked. Well, I'm trying to understand.
Come on, preacher.
They was naked all along.
Right.
Come on here.
But down. They come to a realization that they are naked. Now the reason why they knew that they were naked now is because they had now sinned. Originally they were clothed with the glory of God. But when they sinned, the glory of God departed. And then they realized they had no more covering. And they realized they were naked. And they were ashamed. I'm going to send a new to you. It'll make you ashamed. It'll bring you in the dirt. It'll bring you down in the dirt. It'll make you ashamed. They were ashamed. And they made fig leaves. Fig leaves represents, or it speaks of, of man's righteousness.
That's right.
It speaks of man's justification of sin. It speaks of man's religion that says he's okay as long as he's on somebody's roll book. That says he's okay as long as he goes to church every Sunday. That he's okay if he's singing the choir. That he's okay if he's starting the deacon board. When Jesus came on the scene, there was only one tree, one kind of tree that Jesus cursed.
That's right.
Do you remember that? What kind of tree was it? What kind of tree was it? Isn't that right? Why would he come on the scene and curse a fig tree in particular? He was showing us, that man's religion, man's righteousness is useless before God. Jesus said, I am the way.
Come on.
Yeah. I am the truth. Yeah. And the life.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, no man coming to the Father but by me. Title shall glory. Look at Genesis. Let's look at the third chapter, verses 8 through 11. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. Cool, God.
Yeah.
God is all right. Walking in the cool.
He
chose the hot part of the nation.
All right.
Thank God, God is all right.
Yeah.
And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord, God among the trees. But God is so merciful, isn't he?
Amen.
He knew Adam and Eve had sinned.
Amen.
But he always gave me a chance to repent.
That's right.
So he was trying to give Adam and Eve a chance to repent. So he got and said, where are you?
Yeah.
He said, well, I heard your voice in the garden.
Yeah.
And I was afraid.
Yeah.
Why? Because I was naked.
Yeah.
I was naked.
Yeah.
And I hid myself.
Yes, sir.
And God said, Who told you that you were naked?
Come on here, preacher.
Who told you that?